sa akong panantaw ang among panagatong minus na gyud compare sa una.
Niadto kay daghan man kadtong shells nang pinason karon wa naman minus naman. Uban ko sang bana kay magligo-ligo pud mi ba.
Niadtong unang panahon makakuha ko tagutlo ka kilo, tagurha, ana.
Karon kay daghan na sang population mao nang daghan na pong manguha di mo nang minus-minus pero na ang happy kinason.
Karon dito ko ginis dagat wa na nung ko ikuha wa ko kakuha ron.
Hi, my name is Alessia Kockel. I'm a graduate student with the Marine Protected Areas Research Group at the University of Victoria, located in Canada. My research takes place in Sogod Bay, which is located in the eastern Visayan region of the Philippines.
The entire area for that Sogod Bay is, I think it's 100,000 hectares. Sogod Bay composed of 11 municipalities: Asawa, Padriburgos, Malitbog, Tumasopos, Buntok, Sugod, Libagon, Liloan, San Francisco, Pintuyan, and San Ricardo.
Like so many places in the world, the coral reef, mangrove habitats, and seagrass beds in Sogod Bay are in continuous decline.
Marine ecosystems are really important for places like the Philippines. There are so many people that rely on those ecosystems. People who fish, people who rely on jobs such as tourism or commercial fishing. So that's why it's so important to have healthy marine ecosystems so that they can support people.
Throughout the world now, we have a challenge with fisheries resources, not just in Southeast Asia, it's not just in Africa, it's not just in South America, it's not just in Canada. Everywhere is the same, in that fishery catches are declining.
The main approach used in the Philippines to address the threats to biodiversity and fisheries is through the establishment of marine protected areas, also known as MPAs.
A marine protected area, or an MPA, is an area of the ocean where human activity is restricted in some way by law. By restricting human activities and access, MPAs can help protect marine habitats, endangered species, and declining fish stocks. Several studies have shown that MPAs can over time increase the biomass, density, and even the number of fish species within their boundaries. They can also increase the size and life expectancy of fish, which is really important since older and larger fish tend to lay more eggs than smaller fish. MPAs can also provide a lot of benefits to fisher folks outside of their boundaries. And this is because as fish populations recover within a given MPA, some of the fish, along with their eggs and young, may move to areas outside of the MPA where they then become available for fishing. This benefit is what we refer to as the spillover effect.
So our next step as researchers is going to be to present these plans and different options of where MPAs could be located in the bay back to local communities. Hopefully, with a lot of discussion and through collaborating with each other, we can come up with some MPA network plans and implement them in the future.
Binis among barangay wa pa ang padre. Para naho, awak mo apil kung bantay anang dapita kay para po niya katong mamasulay puhon nga moabot, ma sila na po'y makatagamtam maubay-ubay naman ng atong isda din sa atong nai atong gitawag og pisantuare na na.
Na, kadi na kaya ng mga tiguang lo yan. Ngayon na lang mali pang balas kan yun. Wa na na time. Pero kami ayuda-ayuda lang maginagmay og suporta og ginagmay. Pero kami papulihok din na kaya nakapagpapao.
Napabayon ngay makao na to sa maabot. Kung dapat ba tayo panghinambong sa atong mga anak na kini nga area amo ang gibantayan. Buta, kamo na buron niya ang musulod. Mangi o tali na nga. Please, bantayan po ni Mineria para makakaon po tao. Thank you.